What's the difference between Windows Home and Pro editions? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. The differences have been getting a little bit muddier over the years, perhaps even fewer differences, but there are some very specific differences between the Home and Pro editions. Home, of course, comes pre-installed on many consumer machines, and Pro actually comes pre-installed on many business machines. What's the difference? Well, let's take a quick look at what the highlights are. The big difference that actually impacts my ability to answer questions sometimes is the Group Policy Editor. The Group Policy Editor allows you to make configuration changes to Windows. Windows Pro has a Group Policy Editor. Windows Home does not. If there are changes to be made, what that means is that in Home, you're often either not making those changes or you have to dive into the registry to make those changes manually, which includes its own level of risk. Group Policy Editor is a nice way of mitigating that risk by not forcing you to go into the registry, but in fact exposing specific settings one way or another. Another option is Remote Desktop. Now, Remote Desktop Client is present in both Home and Pro. What that means is that you can, from a Windows 10 Home machine, use the Remote Desktop Client to connect to another machine. But that other machine can't be Windows 10 Home or Windows 11 Home. It needs to be a Pro edition or better. By better, I mean an Enterprise edition or one of the other editions that are available. But the actual ability to connect to your machine using a remote desktop requires that you be running Windows Pro Edition. Now, to be clear, this has nothing to do with third-party remote desktop applications. TeamViewer, remote PC, Chrome remote desktop, those all work in all of the editions. This is only about the remote desktop service in Windows itself. It's only there in Pro, not in Home, but the client that you can use to connect to a different machine is present in both. BitLocker gets really confusing. It got much more confusing in recent editions of Windows Home, and that's because hard disks are showing up encrypted, and they're encrypted using BitLocker technology. But the user interface, the control you might want to have over BitLocker, is not present in Home. Windows Pro Editions has the full interface for BitLocker, allowing you to use BitLocker on folders or USB drives or your internal hard drive. Windows Home has full disk encryption, it turns out, that's actually enabled by the BitLocker technology. You just don't find BitLocker referenced in any of the controls that you have available to you. And finally, the one that I think probably makes the most difference to some folks is what I'll call Windows Update for Business. Windows Update, very controversial. They've taken away a lot of control that we were used to having in previous versions of Windows. It's been this way now for several years. With Windows Pro Editions, you have the ability to pause Windows Update for a longer period of time than you do with Windows Home. Windows Home, I believe you can pause it like for a few days, but you're going to get Windows Update running. With Windows Pro Edition, you can, of course, pause it for something like up to 5 weeks, which could be really important in a business environment or if you're giving presentations or who knows what. You just know that Windows Update isn't going to happen for a while. So that's one difference that I think also points a lot of people at getting the Pro Edition of Windows if it's available to them. Now, of course, there are a lot of other differences, small differences under the hood, a lot of fancy names for features that honestly you and I rarely, if ever, actually use. However, in the companion article for this video, I do have the links to Microsoft's own comparison for both Windows 10 Home and Pro Editions and Windows 11 Home and Pro Editions. That's at askleo.com/39397. The other difference, very clearly, is price. Windows 10, Windows 11 Pro comes at a premium. It costs more than Windows Home. Is it worth it? It's hard for me to judge because it really depends on your budget and your needs. I consider it important enough. I want Remote Desktop. I want Group Policy Editor. I'm kind of on the fence about Windows Update delays, but the bottom line is those features, you need to evaluate whether or not those features really are important to you, how important they are to you, whether or not you've got alternatives in some cases, for example, there are alternatives to using BitLocker. But the bottom line is that when in doubt, if you've got the budget for it, I actually do recommend Windows Pro. It's what I run myself, and it's what makes my job a little bit easier when you are running it as well. Hopefully that helps. Like I said, the links for the comparisons provided by Microsoft for any updates, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/39397. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.